Hej, hej, witamy wszystkich bardzo serdecznie, a wraz z nami na wizji jest już pani Aleksandra Kowalska, która poprowadzi dla Was dzisiejszą lekcję.
Witam serdecznie. Hello, welcome. On this beautiful day, which is really, really hot, and believe me, we have such high temperature here that we can't stand it. Słuchajcie, jak my tu mamy gorąco, to nie macie pojęcia, a jeszcze mi tu w oczy daje taka lampa. Grzeje strasznie, no ale postaram się, żeby jakoś wytrzymać przez te 25 minut. Mam dzisiaj dla Was lekcję o futbolu, właściwie o piłce nożnej, czyli o soccerze, soccer, cricket and rugby. A w tytule napisałam futbol, dlatego że w Wielkiej Brytanii mówi się na to futbol, a w Stanach Zjednoczonych używamy nazwy soccer ze względu na to, że futbol ważniejszy dla nich jest ten amerykański. Ale przejdźmy już do rzeczy. Let's start with football. So everybody plays football, right? Everybody, I think every boy and almost every girl has tried football in their life. And this game, as the other two games, is very popular among British people. And I would say they are actually the most British games. So let's start with the history of football. So it's an old sport, it really is. And the whole story started in England in the 12th century. So imagine nearly 1,000 years ago, people played something similar to football, but it wasn't a game like it is now because it involved a lot of violence, a lot of kicking, a lot of punching, a lot of beating up other players. And because it was so dangerous and so harmful for the players, King Richard II banned this game in the 14th century. Ta gra była tak niebezpieczna i tak bym powiedziała rough, po angielsku się mówi, że po prostu w XIV wieku król Ryszard II zakazał ze względu na konsekwencje. Także wyobraźcie sobie, jaką ewolucję piłka nożna przeszła do dnia dzisiejszego. Apart from kicks, players also punched the ball with their fists. Oprócz właśnie tradycyjnego kopania piłki, można było piłkę również uderzać pięścią. Więc dlatego ta gra była też niebezpieczna, bo czasem ręka się omsknęła i zamiast piłkę, to ktoś mógł dostać w oko. The early games would cause damage on the town and sometimes death to players. So it was really dangerous. That's why the king decided to stop this game so that people kind of cool off and maybe regulate the game with some decent rules that wouldn't cause so much damage. And football became like a top game in the 19th century, and its modern history is known to everybody, I think, because everybody knows about world championships and everybody has heard about world leagues and leagues in UK and leagues in Germany, for example. And it's a very popular game all over the world. So why is it popular? In England, there are more than 50,000 football clubs in the UK, and there are 5 Premiership clubs in London, so that's a lot. There are also other clubs which are not so top class, but there are many places in which you can play football. And 240 million people in more than 200 countries play football just for fun, so for relaxation. A lot of people watch football matches in stadiums or on TV. I hope to watch the last match of our team, which was actually on Tuesday, and I hope you you keep your fingers crossed for the upcoming Euro tournament. In Britain, it is popular to watch important matches at the pubs on big screens. I think it's becoming popular in Poland as well. Maybe now, when the restrictions connected with COVID pandemic are kind of lesser than the way than they were before, we will also go and watch football on big screens in pubs or maybe in town squares, in town centers. And England is actually the country which made the rules of football, and therefore the measurements, how big the football pitches are, is always the measurement is always given in English, in yards, not in meters, and I hope you've noticed that. Słuchajcie, właśnie dlatego najczęściej podaje się wymiary boiska, do piłki nożnej w jardach, bo Anglicy sformalizowali tą grę i tak jakby stworzyli jej zasady, żeby już nie była taka niebezpieczna, jak była na początku swojej historii, czyli w XII i XIV wieku, chociaż słyszałam, że nawet ta historia jest dłuższa i sięga jeszcze tam starożytnej Grecji. Okay, football vocabulary. So first of all, we've got the word which is called the score. This means all the points per team, right? The team scores. The goalkeeper is the person who stops the goals from coming into the goal. A pitch is the place where footballers kind of carry out the game, run on it. The kickoff, it's the first kick of the match. And those are like the four words that you should know if you want to learn something about football and you want to know the English vocabulary connected with it. Also, you should know who the referee is. The referee is the person who controls the game, and the referee is the person who basically tells whether the players are playing fair or not, right? To jest po prostu sędzia. The goalkeeper, I mentioned, is the person who stops the goals. Training is the practice and exercise to achieve your aims, right? To get what you want. Halftime is the break after 45 minutes of play, right? Halftime, czyli w połowie, przerwa, połówka. Po 45 minutach właśnie nazywa się halftime. The fans are the followers, the supporters of the team who often travel with their favorite footballers and follow them. Then we've got the chant, which is kind of a song that is sung by supporters, but by fans of footballers. And there are different chants for different clubs in UK. The coach is the person who trains the footballers and tells them what strategy they should use and what they should do to become better. And the next sport is rugby, and what you can see here is a rugby scrum. I'm going to explain later what it is, and I would like to make sure that you know that not only men play rugby and football, also women play rugby and football. And here we've got another picture of the scrum. There are two different kinds of rugby with slightly different rules. There is rugby union and rugby league. And the common thing about them is the equipment and the shape of a ball and the number of players. So the shape of a rugby ball, it's kind of, I would say, oblique. It makes the ball easy to carry. And in the past, this ball was made from leather. Now it's synthetic, but it's easy to carry under your kind of arm. Rugby players are extremely famous, not in Poland, but in the countries where rugby is popular. They are really, really well known. And because rugby is a physical game, rugby players also have to be very strong apart from being fit. And also rugby is now, I think rugby is more violent than football, and you can see it during the game. Rugby players are dirty after the game and they've got a lot of bruises and they really do a lot of work and they move a lot. Rugby scrum, what you see in the picture, is when you see the players with their heads down and they are kind of moving to one side or to the other. And that's called the scrum, and it is very difficult to break the scrum, but that's the thing you have to do. You have to break the scrum and get the ball. And there are two halves in a game of rugby. Each of them is 40 minutes long. And as I mentioned, men and women can play rugby. Rugby is also an old game, and it started by accident in England, of course, at a rugby school in 1823, when a young boy, his name was William Webb Ellis, basically during a game of football, decided to pick up the ball and carry it to the goal. And he started running with it, and the teachers thought it was a good idea. And they decided kind of to make this a rule and create a new game. And in 1871, the Rugby Football Union set the rules of the new game and the history of regulation started. In 1895, there was the first international match between Scotland and England. And I think you should also know something about rugby equipment. So, as I mentioned, you need a lot of protection, right? Because it's a very physical game. The first thing is a gum shield. A gum shield in Polish is osłona na na szczękę, na dziąsła, it protects player's teeth and gums. Ona chroni, ma zadanie chronić zęby i dziąsła i szczęki graczy. Rugby shorts are slightly different than football shorts and they are made of cotton, but they must be very strong. Ponieważ rugbyści potrafią się ciągnąć za spodnie, to ich naprawdę krótkie spodenki muszą być z dobrego materiału i to są takie rzeczy, na które mówimy, że są durable, czyli są w stanie dużo wytrzymać. Helmet, because it's dangerous not to have a helmet on your head when you end up with your head down on the ground. And the helmet is made of light plastic material and it protects the head. I takie hełmy do rugby, kaski do rugby są bardzo lekkie i one są z takiego plastiku zbudowane i pozwalają po prostu ochronić głowę przed uderzeniami. No i oczywiście socks. Because the players can kick each other. Socks are important as they keep the players' feet from rubbing against the boots. No właśnie, i jeszcze to jest taka jakby wskazóweczka, że te skarpety, które są troszeczkę wyższe, pozwalają tak jakby mniejszy mieć poślizg, jak się w rugby gra. Rugby ball, it's special, it's made from leather, but it's also synthetic now and it's easy to hold in the rain. And in the picture, you can see a very famous thing because New Zealand is in New Zealand, rugby is very popular. And here you can see one team during the haka, doing the haka. And I mentioned what it is before, it's kind of a tribal dance to show how strong you are. And in a rugby game in New Zealand, you would always see a haka at the beginning. Upper body protection is sometimes used by rugby players. It is worn under t-shirts and there is a padding for shoulders so that your shoulders don't get hurt. Rugby boots are similar to football boots because you also run on the grass. And the rugby shirt, sometimes it's called jersey, and as rugby short, it needs to be made from a durable material, it needs to be strong. And cricket, this is a strange game. Słuchajcie, cricket to jest dziwna gra, my w ogóle jej nie rozumiemy. Ja spróbuję wam troszeczkę wytłumaczyć, o co w krykecie chodzi, ale to nie jest prosta sprawa. Dla takich zapalonych anglofilów polecam pooglądać sobie na YouTubie różne tutoriale. Bo nie jest prosta sprawa zrozumieć, dlaczego niektóre mecze krykieta potrafią trwać kilka dni i odbywają się z przerwami, ale główne zasady możemy sobie omówić. Jak mówiłam, to również jest bardzo angielska gra i zaczniemy sobie o faktach. It started in the 1300. Zaczęło się bardzo dawno, bo mniej więcej około 1300 roku. It's played all over the world, but mainly in former British colonies. So you would see it in Australia, in New Zealand, in England, in Scotland, in Ireland, in Canada, in India, in South African Republic, in countries where football is not so popular. Cricket has complicated rules. I will try to explain some of them, but they are really complicated. And cricket players usually wear white clothes, but all colors are allowed. In the past, they used to wear only white, but now they can wear anything they want. They used to wear sweaters, but now they wear t-shirts and trousers. A cricket game can be really long, as I mentioned, even a few days. And what are the rules? The rules are not simple. First of all, there are two teams. Each team must have 11 players. One team bats and the other team bowls. What does it mean? It means that to bat is to use the bat, the special kind of stick, right? And to bowl is to throw the ball. So that's what batting and bowling means. And the team who is battling has two players on the pitch. And the fielding team, so the other team who is bowling, has got 11 players on the pitch. And the team with the bat hits the ball, right? The team with the ball bowls the ball. And the battling team tries to score runs. So those two men who are the battlers, they have to run around the field. The fielders from the bowling team, they try to get the batsman out by hitting a wicket. And you can see the wicket in the picture is this construction, wooden, usually wooden construction, which needs to be kind of thrown over. And the team which has most points wins. The best thing is to actually watch a game, and then you will see what it actually is all about, because it's really hard to explain it when I don't have any fielders and a batsman and bowlers here. So a fielder, you can see the fielders here. A fielder is the player who kind of looks around, and they have to either catch the ball and throw it into the wicket, or stop the batsman from running. This is the batsman, and you can see the cricket bat he's got here. And the batsman tries to hit the ball and do the runs. This is the wicket, and the object of the game is to kind of throw down this wicket. That's when the runs stop. Cricket ball is usually made of leather, and it's kind of I think it's kind of similar to baseball ball. It's made of leather, and it's very, very durable, very strong, and kind of heavy comparing with, for example, a tennis ball. Cricket pitch looks like that, and you've got it's divided into three main sections, right? You've got one side for the fielder and one side for the wicket, one side for the bowler, one side for the wicket, and basically the team who is battling, they have to run around this field. A cricket bat looks like that. It's a little bit similar to baseball bat, but it's not kind of round in shape, it's flat. And now you can even buy such bats in Poland and try to play cricket yourself. Okay, so thank you, and see you in a minute in our lesson about